meteorologist Cameron Moreland.
With highs in the upper 20s to lower 30s today, it was the coldest day in about a week. Tomorrow's going to be even colder, and then we've got another warm-up on the way. Here's a look at the next 7 days. Look for highs tomorrow to be mainly in the mid-20s. We'll see mid to upper 30s on Thursday, 40s on Friday, before it turns slightly colder as we head through the weekend into early next week. Right now, we are looking at mainly 20s out there. It is currently 24 degrees in Mountain. We've got 25 in Oconto, and it's 28 degrees in Oshkosh. In Green Bay, after cloudy skies pretty much all day long, the skies have now cleared out just a bit. It is 27 degrees. In Appleton, we're still looking at partly to mostly cloudy conditions. The temperature is 27, and we have northwest winds at around 10 miles per hour. Not as strong as the winds that we had earlier today when they were still gusting 20 to 25 miles per hour at times, but still strong enough to produce a wind chill factor in a few spots here. It feels like 11 in Sturgeon Bay, and it currently feels like 16 degrees in Manitowoc. With the clouds breaking up, we have dry weather across northeast Wisconsin this evening. Really not a whole lot going on across the upper Midwest. Just a little bit of lake effect snow coming in off Lake Superior. That'll stay to our north. The satellite picture shows abundant clouds across the Badger State. You can see that little break there right over Green Bay back towards Clintonville. But for the most part, we have mostly cloudy conditions. Having said that, high pressure is going to slowly build in here throughout the night into tomorrow, and that means we will start to break those clouds apart. Temperatures this afternoon, we're only in the 20s across much of Wisconsin. To our west, we had mid to upper 20s, even lower to mid 20s here towards Fargo. This is the air mass that's going to move overhead for tomorrow, but if you look off towards the west, temperatures were back up into the 30s and 40s, and that is a warm-up. Temperatures this afternoon in Pierre and Bismarck running 10 to almost 20 degrees warmer today compared to yesterday, and that's the warmer weather that's going to move back in here by the time we get to Thursday and Friday. Tomorrow, seasonable conditions. We'll see a mixture of clouds and some sunshine. Look for a high temperature right around 24. That's where we should be for this time of year. As we head into Friday and Thursday, look for a mixture of clouds and sunshine and warmer temperatures. By Thursday afternoon, we will be looking at mid to upper 30s across most of the viewing area. Then by Friday, temperatures will be climbing up into the mid 40s. Some spots could hit the upper 40s. So your forecast for tonight calls for slowly dissipating clouds. Temperatures will drop down to around 10. We'll call it a mixture of stars and clouds throughout the night. And then tomorrow, a mixture of sun and clouds. Certainly a lot more sunshine tomorrow than what we saw today. Look for a high temperature right around 24 degrees. That is my 3-degree guarantee for tomorrow. If I can hit that high within 3 degrees, we will donate $100 to St. John's Shelter in Green Bay, and we did that today. I forecast 31, and the actual high temperature was 30, which means I've now hit 31 of the last 31 3-degree guarantee forecasts. On Thursday, look for 35, 45 on Friday. A cold front moves through early Saturday morning. Behind it, some cooler conditions, but well above normal. Temperatures will be in the upper 30s. We'll see a high right around 30 on Sunday. We'll cool down to 25 on Monday. That's still above normal for this time of year. And then we will start to warm up again as we head towards the middle and end of next week. All right, I do want to say a quick hello to all of the eighth graders at Providence Academy in Green Bay. I was there earlier this morning talking about the weather. And one of the fun facts I pointed out was that back in the winter of 95-96, Hurley, Wisconsin picked up over 295 inches of snow, Regina. And that is the greatest seasonal snowfall here in the state of Wisconsin.
What year was that again?
95-96. I was living in Rhinelander, and we had probably about 140 to 150 inches in Rhinelander.
Oh, my gosh. Well, thank God I was here that time.
That's too much snow for
that's
you,
That's
huh?
too much a little bit.
Yeah,
but
this year we've only had about 16, 17 inches in the Fox Valley.
Okay, that's doable, I think. All right, Cameron, thanks for that. Well, after the break, the latest from Kentucky, where a community is in shock after a deadly school shooting. This is NBC 26 at 5. Shots rang out.